Hello and welcome to What in the World. This is a show where enterprise geo-Googlers look at something interesting in the product. My name's Dylan Thomas. I'm a community manager on the Maps team. And joining me today is Ujaval Gandhi. Hi, Ujaval.
Hi, Dylan. Thanks for having me here.
Yeah, no problem. And Ujaval is going to be talking about a new open source connector that he's written for the QGIS desktop GIS product. And it lets you work with Google Maps Engine platform quite seamlessly. So why don't you just start maybe by telling us what the reasoning and the impetus was for you to work on this toolbar?
Sure. So the Maps Engine connector for QGIS, it's a Python plugin that lets you access your Maps Engine data within the QGIS desktop environment. Okay. So a lot of times when you are working in a desktop environment, you want access to your Maps Engine layers. And this plugin allows you to securely bring those layers in to QGIS.
Ah, so securely is a pretty important part of what you just said there, right?
Yes.
Okay.
And it also simplifies your workflow, that a lot of times you are editing and preparing your data in a desktop GIS. Mm-hmm. And to upload to Maps Engine, you often need to hunt around for the source files on your desktop.
Oh,
so
yeah,
this
okay.
allows you to work within your environment and press a button to upload the data directly to Maps Engine.
So it's not just viewing it, which is of course one of the things, but it's fitting into an existing workflow for a GIS analyst, for example, to sort of managing their data and then push it to the,
yes.
to the cloud. Okay.
Yes. And a kind of a side benefit of this plugin is that since it runs within the QGIS environment, it can access all the data types that QGIS can read. So a lot of enterprise users use databases like PostGIS to manage the data.
Yeah.
And you could now upload your PostGIS layers directly to Maps Engine through this plugin.
Well, that's pretty key. So we a lot of times in documentation and quick how-tos, you see grab a shapefile, upload it, and that's how you do it. And certainly that's a good way of doing it, but this is much more in line with a process and a workflow, extracting data from your internal database and pushing it up to the
yes,
cloud.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. Okay.
And since the code is open source, it's a great reference for anybody who's looking to develop using Python. You can pretty much drop in the current code into your application and mm-hmm. start building from there. So it gives you a good head start when you're building in Python.
Oh, perfect. Great. So even beyond QGIS, it's just kind of a nice reference implementation, basically.
Yes.
Yeah. So, well, thanks for the intro. That's good to sort of frame what you're going to do next, which I think is demonstrate the connector.
Sure. So, as you can see, I am in my QGIS desktop environment. I've already installed the plugin. This shows up as a toolbar. The plugin is available in the QGIS plugin repository, so it's a one-click install, and you get updates directly from into QGIS. So the first thing to do is to log in. So let me just. Now this uses OAuth 2 flow to authenticate my credentials. And once the login is successful, I get an authentication token back from the server. And this is the access token that is used by the API to get your private data from Maps Engine in a secure way.
Key point there, you mentioned the API. So this is actually not just a reference implementation for QGIS plugin and Python, but this is a really great example of how to use our Maps Engine API.
Yes.
And so during the authentication flow there, you presumably want to make sure you're in the right access control group as well, sort
yes.
of set that up on the server beforehand so that you can do this stuff.
Yes.
Okay.
So once you are successfully logged in, you can see that the search tool is enabled now, and you can search for the maps that you have access to.
Mm-hmm.
You can look at different accounts as well as the different maps you have. So let's load up this map from Natural Earth here. Now what this does, it doesn't actually load the map data, but it fetches a bounding box layer from using the API that shows what layers you have in your map and what are their extents. And it loads it up here. Once you have this layer loaded, you can see the view tools are all enabled now. And you can use the WMS tool to get your data via WMS into your desktop. So let's just do that. And this shows the couple of layers that are contained in this map. You can select the formats and the projection and click Add. And this is fetching the data from Google Maps Engine as a WMS layer. And you can see you can interact it now, just like it was another QGIS layer.
Perfect. Now, that's a nice touch. I like how you did the sort of getting the metadata first so that you're not just sucking up API usage, browsing around, trying to figure out where the data is that you want.
Yes. So another thing I can quickly show is data uploading. So I've already loaded a layer here. This is an SQLite layer, Spatialite layer, which is loaded into QGIS. And now you are able to upload this data format into Maps Engine through QGIS. So if you select any of the supported layer types, the Interact tool becomes active. You can just click on the Upload button and see that there's a source. You can see the SQLite source here. And you can rename the layer if you wanted to, add a description, and put the access list to which this data would be accessible. In this case, I'm going to make it accessible to the connector editors. You can add a tag if you wanted to, and just click OK. So what is doing it right now is it's extracting the data mm-hmm. from the SQLite yeah. database and uploading the data as a shapefile.
Okay. So you are actually doing the shapefile thing in the background.
Yes. All right. So the data is now uploaded to Maps Engine, and as you can see here, it's uploaded as a shapefile, and you can see your vector data source in Maps Engine.
Well, that's a really nice round trip, I guess. Then you can sort of view the same thing back in yes. In the connector or any other client.
Yes.
That's great. So the other thing I want to touch on briefly is the source code. That's the other interesting aspect of this. Is that something you could show us now? This is on GitHub, right?
Yes. So the code lives at github.com/googlemaps.
And we'll include a URL to this in the video so that you can go visit this yourself.
So as you can see, this is the code repository. It's got a nice README file at the top, which explains what the different tools do and how some of the
I guess the tools work. Yeah, and, yeah. Most important thing for an open source project is a good README file, right?
Yes.
I was going to ask whether you're accepting contributions. Then I see we talked earlier about you've already got one.
Yes, so that was great. We already merged a pull request from a QGIS developer, and we're looking for more contributions.
Excellent. So the future is bright. Yes. And I'm sure you wrote amazing code, but you know there's always room for additions or improvements, right?
Definitely. And if anybody finds a bug or has a feature request, we'll be happy to look into those as well.
Perfect. One final question I wanted to ask you is just sort of revisit that topic of the API. So it does use the Maps Engine API. So how would you suggest people use this in a production environment? Would the example want to upload something that has 2 million features in it? You know, or would you want to do a little edit on one feature using the connector? I mean, the sort of API consumption is part of the whole, that's how it works, right? So you want to keep an eye on that.
Yes, so this uses, when the connector is first loaded, mm-hmm. it would prompt you to enter your client ID and client secret,
yeah.
which you get from your API console. So this will use up the API quota from that. So you need to keep an eye on that as well.
Okay. But then I think the thing you were showing, though, is also it uses basically file upload, ultimately,
yes.
as that's working. So
yes.
if you wanted to, it's not like you're editing a million feature polygon, for example, right, in the connector. You're doing a bulk upload.
Yes.
Ultimately.
So it just every time it uploads the entire file.
Okay, great. That's really good to know for the workflow, and it's good to know for API consumption.
Yes.
So great, Ujaval. Thank you so much for coming and showing this today. I'm really glad you wrote the connector, and hopefully we get some great contributions from our open source users.
Thanks. It was nice being here.
All right, and that's it for What in the World. We'll see you next time.